What's up, guys? So one of the main concerns people have with electric cars is how to charge them. And one of the easiest ways to do just that is to charge at home. So in today's video, I'm going to take you through the process of getting a home charger installed, in addition to providing an overview of the costs involved and what it's like to use the system on a daily basis. So let's get started. When it comes to installing a home charger for your electric vehicle, there are a variety of options available. Most utility providers now offer a wide array of charging solutions at discounted rates, including installation and delivery costs. Electric Ireland, for example, offered to provide and install a domestic charger for €499 after the €600 government grant is applied, while other third-party chargers, such as Zappi, can be purchased online, leaving you to source your own local electrician to perform the installation. In the case of Tesla vehicles, Tesla manufacture their own domestic charging units, which can be purchased directly from the Tesla online store for €530. So what's the difference between a Tesla charger and any other domestic charger that you could buy from your utility provider or online? Well, in most cases, the domestic chargers installed by your utility provider will basically look like an industrial electrical outlet. To use it, you'll have to use the public charging cable which came with your car to connect between the charger and the charge port. The Tesla charger, on the other hand, comes with its own permanently attached cable, which can be configured in two sizes, 2.5 meters or 7.5 meters. And this adds some extra convenience for when you want to plug in your car quickly without having to unpack and connect a separate cable. The next difference comes with the charger itself. If you purchase a Tesla charger, then the charge connector comes with an inbuilt button which enables you to remotely open the charge port door when you want to insert the charger and begin charging. When you're finished charging, the same button can be used to unlock the cable from the charge port and remove it from the car. If you use a non-Tesla charger, then the cable will not come with this functionality, meaning that you'll have to manually unlock the cable from the charge port using either the Tesla app on your smartphone, the center touchscreen, or the Tesla key fob if you have one. And finally, if you have multiple electric cars at your home and you want to charge them all at the same time, then Tesla's chargers feature inbuilt load balancing technology, which dynamically allocates power in accordance with demand. In terms of power output, most domestic chargers are limited by the electricity supply to your home as opposed to a limitation of the charger itself, which means that in the majority of cases, the maximum power output of your charger is going to be 7.4 kilowatts. The only exception to this would be in the case that your home has a three-phase power supply, in which case the maximum power output of the Tesla wall charger is 22 kilowatts. However, one key thing to note about this is that the power output of any domestic charger, be it single phase or three phase, will still be an AC or alternating current power source. This means that fundamentally, the power output will be limited by the onboard AC to DC converter in your Model 3, which has a maximum power output of 11 kilowatts. This means that even if you do have a 22 kilowatt power supply, you'll still only be able to charge at a maximum rate of 11 kilowatts. The next thing to note about installing a domestic charger is the government grant. The Sustainable Energy Authority of Ireland, or SEAI, provide a grant of up to €600 towards the purchase and installation of a domestic charger. If you want to get this grant, you'll need to apply via the SEAI website prior to purchasing or installing the charger. Once you've made your online application, then you'll receive a letter of offer in the post, after which you can order the charger and prepare for installation. It's important to remember that the grant is contingent on the installation being performed by an SEAI registered electrician, so be sure to keep this in mind when you're sourcing a local installer. Once the installation is complete, you'll need to provide a number of supporting documents to verify that it was performed correctly, most of which are listed here. In this regard, the SEAI are quite pedantic about documentation, and in my case, I actually had to resubmit some of the forms due to some very minor omissions. Another factor to consider is the application processing time, which can take anywhere between 6 to 12 weeks or longer. In my case, after I resubmitted my documents, I received an email to state that I'd be waiting another 4 to 6 weeks for them to process my application, and to date I'm still waiting to receive the grant. Moving back to the charger itself, once I received my letter of offer, I ordered a Tesla wall connector from the Tesla online store and sourced a local SEAI registered electrician to perform the installation. The installation itself took about 2 hours and was a very smooth process since the charger was installed on the external wall just behind the fuse box. If you have any high power appliances in the house, like an electric shower for example, then you'll typically need to install a priority switch so you don't trip a fuse when both the shower and charger are being used at the same time. This is generally the most expensive component of the installation, aside from the charger itself, with an average cost of between 150 to 200 euros for the priority unit. All said and done, my final installation cost came to 200 euros since I didn't need to get the priority switch, and when we factor in the cost of the charger itself, coupled with the SEAI grant deduction, this ultimately left me with a net cost of about 130 euros for the entire system, which is very reasonable. The final installation was very clean. As you can see, the charger itself is very minimalist and well designed, while its IP44 water resistance rating means that it can be installed inside or outside without issue. The version I bought came with the longer 7.5 meter cable, which, while a little unwieldy, does offer the extra convenience of being able to use the charger from a further distance. When not in use, the cable simply wraps around the outside of the charger housing and the connector is held in place by a little holster on the side. In terms of using the charger, you can simply take the connector out of the holster, press the button at the top of the connector to remotely open the charge port and plug in. Once the car starts charging, you'll see a charging animation on the charger itself, in addition to the usual information displayed inside the car on the center touchscreen. In my case, since I have a standard single phase power supply, the maximum power output from the charger is 7.4 kilowatts. As a result, you can see that based on the charging estimate, the charge rate is quite slow in comparison to a standard AC public charger, and especially slow in comparison to any DC fast charger. However, it is about 3 times faster than the standard 3-pin mobile charger that comes with the car, so this is a significant improvement. In my case, if I were to fully charge the car, it would take approximately 10 to 12 hours to charge from 0 to 100%. However, this is an extreme case. On average, most people would be charging from approximately 50 to 80% on a daily basis, which would take approximately 4 hours on the domestic charger. In terms of cost, you can look at the per kilowatt hour energy rate on your electricity bill to determine roughly how much it would cost to fully charge the car. In my case, Electric Ireland charged me at a rate of 17 cents per kilowatt hour, which, when multiplied by the size of the Model 3 battery pack, gives a cost estimate of about 14 euros to fully charge the car from 0 to 100%. Of course, these prices would vary significantly depending on your provider, so you'll need to do your own calculations to assess how much it would cost for you to charge from home. Another way costs can vary is with nitrate electricity. With nitrate tariffs, you could make significant savings by charging your car at home overnight on a regular basis. However, one thing to note about nitrate tariffs is that while the overnight per kilowatt hour rate drops significantly in price, the daytime rate is actually higher than it would be on a standard bill. This means that if you're the type of person who regularly charges at work or at public charging stations, then switching to nitrate electricity mightn't necessarily result in the savings you'd expect. So be sure to do your homework before you make the switch. So what are my thoughts on home charging? Well, although I do most of my charging at work and on the go, I still do get peace of mind out of being able to charge the car from home should the need ever arise. While the average installation cost of 400 to 500 euros might be a deterrent for some people, compared to the over 24 hours it would take to charge the car using the standard 3-pin mobile connector, a dedicated home charging solution does offer significant advantages both in terms of practicality and convenience. With regards to the charger itself, whether you decide to go for a Tesla charger or a third-party charger is entirely a matter of personal preference, with each offering their own distinct advantages and disadvantages in terms of cost and features. While Tesla's charger does offer the unique ability to remotely control the charge port door, it is lacking in some of the smart connected features that other chargers are now offering at a similar price point. And as for the SEAI grant, all I can say is that a bit of patience will go a long way. So that's it for today's video. I hope you found it useful and informative, particularly if you're considering buying a home charger for the first time. As always, if you have any questions or suggestions, do let me know in the comments, and be sure to subscribe to the channel for more Tesla videos like this one every week. Until then, I'll see you in the next one.